So we have the pleasure of having with us one of the directors of the hands-on schools, Maria Liz Crespo. So in addition to what she's going to do is tell us about how to have fun this weekend, she is largely responsible for getting everything put together up at the M Lab for the hands-on sessions, getting all the bits and pieces of chemicals and equipment and everything. So she's played a huge role in making the hands-on schools go really smoothly. So I would ask that we give her a nice round of applause.
Thank you.
So, and I'm
Thank
going
you,
to go ahead and then now turn it over to Maria Liz to tell us about what we can do around here over the weekend.
Good. Okay, so.
We just need to switch you over.
Ah, okay, yes, sorry. Sorry, I should do it. Okay, so, as Mike said, my name is Maria Liz Crespo. I am a research officer at the Multidisciplinary Laboratory, the place where you made the hands-on part of this activity. It's a big pleasure to me to collaborate with these fantastic the directors and lecturers of this activity. I am the local organizer of this activity, more than the director, I would say. And I am not Italian. I'm from Argentina. I came here to make my PhD, and then I'm working here since 1998. So I live in Italy from that time. So I have, I know more or less the well, I would say the area. It is here to give you some advice about what you can do during this weekend. No, there is a very important thing is of course to visit the city, to visit Trieste. I took from the from InfoPoint maps. With information about the city, about the main place or the place more interesting to visit. So, if it is not the quantity is not enough for every of you, so I would like to ask you to please share the maps. In the map, there is also information in English about every of the place you can visit. There is this small map, but there is a second one that have also information about different possibilities in Trieste and around Trieste. I put in this slide just to give you an example, Piazza Unità d'Italia. I don't know if you already visit the Piazza Unità Square. It's the main square in the center of the city, and it's the Europe largest square overlooking the sea. It's very, very nice square. And it's interesting, it's nice to see the square during the day and also during the night. There are very nice lights. It's a very, very, very interesting place to visit, the center of city. There is also the Canal Grande, is the name, it's a channel. It's very, very close to the square. And if you want to see that, you can see following the indications on the map. But if you would like, for example, to have a guide visit, you can go. It's written in the slide at 10:30. You can go to the info point that is situated in on the corner of Piazza Unità Square. So it's easy to get there, and the price of a guide visit around the cities now night euro, and you can go there tomorrow or after tomorrow at 10:30. Otherwise, you can arrange yourself with the information you have in the map. I think maybe it's enough, no? One of the more appreciated places of this area is the castle and park of Miramare. So maybe you know that we are very close to the park of Miramare. If you go from here on the left, you will find the entrance of the park. It's a fantastic park. And the entrance of the park is free. There's no cost, so you can just go there and see around and see also the castle from outside. There is a fantastic panoramic view. And from the entrance of the park to arrive by walking to the castle, you will take a 15-20 minutes. So it's very easy to arrive also to the castle, but to enter to the castle, you want to visit the castle with all the very interesting history related to this castle. You can go from 8 a.m. to 7 p.m., and the price is about 8 euro to visit the castle. I have also some leaflets about the here that you can take later about the Miramare Castle. Here you have specific information, but more or less it's the important thing. No? The time is from 8 a.m. to 7 p.m. and the price is around 8 euro. There are also special prices for students, but depend of the age. No? Yes. It's in this period, yes. In this period, it's open every day. Yes. Sorry. Okay, there is another very interesting castle that is very near to the center of the city. The name is San Giusto Castle, and the castle has also a cathedral. To enter to the church is free. It's no cost to enter to the church. You can arrive, it's indicated very clearly in the map. You can arrive by walking without any problem. Otherwise, there is a bus from Piazza Unità, from Piazza Unità Square. That is the bus number 24. To enter to the castle, the opening hours in summer is from 8 a.m. to 7 p.m., and the price here also is Euro 8. Then another very interesting place to visit is also a cave, a very interesting cave that is located 10 kilometers away from the city of Trieste. There is a bus from Piazza Overland, or you can take also the bus from the railway station. It's the bus number 42. And the opening hour of the cave is from 10 a.m. to 6 p.m. And the price is Euro 12. But this is a guide visit. It's very, very interesting. The duration of the visit is 1 hour and a half, but it's very, very, very nice place. You have here also leaflets with this precise information about the cave. Okay, you can take it. But this is some of the examples related with the Trieste city, but you will see that there are other very interesting places in the city. We have in practically every place in Italy has an historical place, and there are rests from the Roman Empire. So there are other places that you can visit without any cost around the center of the city. Then from here is mainly with this temperature, it's very interesting to visit the Adriatic coast by boat. There is here, also you have here a map of the Gulf of Trieste, Golfo di Trieste. We are here in, as you can see, well, it's also there, we are in Grignano. We are in Grignano, but between Grignano and Trieste, you have Barcola. The name is Barcola, and it's a nice place to, if you want, it's to go there for swimming, for example. It's a, there, the sea is like a swimming pool. It's very easy to arrive, and you can arrive by boat from here, from Grignano. Living from here. Normally the ferry departs from Trieste and Sistiana, make an intermediate stop in Barcola and Grignano, which is the place we are, where we are. No? The tickets are sold directly aboard the boat. And I put there some examples about the cost. For example, from Grignano to from here to Trieste is euro 4.25. From and from the, and then you can go to the opposite place that is very nice also, that the name is Sistiana, and there is also a boat to arrive from here to Sistiana, the opposite direction, no? Comparing with Trieste, and the price is 2.55 euro one way here. I took the timetable here. You have several possibilities, several times. You can departure, for example, from Grignano at 8:45, 11:45, 15:15, 18:15, and you have also the time to come back, no? So you have the schedule here, you can take this, and also you have here the price. The prices to go to every point of these four very nice places. I told you that from here to Trieste, you can stop in Barcola. That was very nice place to swim, and also go there are pizzerias and other restaurants and bar and other very nice things to visit. But if you go to the opposite place, you go to Sistiana. Sistiana Bay, in case you prefer, for example, find gravel beach, or find gravel beach, beaches. There is a very nice bay, 230 meters, so you can take the sun there and swim in. There is a very nice place also from Sistiana you can go by walking that is called Porto Piccolo. So advice to go there if you go to Sistiana. And then you can also, there is a very, very nice path. The name is Sentiero Rilke. It's about 2 kilometers. You can go by walking from Sistiana to another place that is called Duino. The panoramic view is fantastic. As you can walk in the middle of the nature, so it's very nice place to go. And if you go from Sistiana to Duino through the Rilke Pass, or Sentiero Rilke, the name in Italiano, you arrive to Duino, and in Duino there is another castle, very nice castle, that is the Castle of Duino. You can visit the castle, there is a picture there, you can visit the castle from 9:30 a.m. to 5:30 p.m., and the price is about Euro 10, depending, because you can visit also the museums, depending of the part of the castle you would like to visit. And this is in case that you don't want to go, you cannot go by boat. You can also arrive there by bus. There is a, you can take from Grignano from here. There is a bus stop here now, you know, in Grignano. That is the bus number 21, or from Strada Costiera. No, from ICTP, let's say from Strada Costiera, you have to go up. There is the, a bus, the company is APT, Gorizia is the bus number 51, that is the bus that go also to the Trieste airport, exactly. So you can take that also to go directly to Sistiana if you don't want to go by boat. Sorry. Then, because you know, as you go, it's the Gulf of Trieste, no? The Gulf of Trieste, so you can arrive from Grignano, you can arrive to Sistiana, then also to Duino. If you continue, you arrive to Monfalcone. Monfalcone is the city that I think that is, you arrive to the international airport of Trieste. You see this city called Monfalcone because the international airport is there. It's in very, very close to Monfalcone city. And then as you continue, you arrive to a fantastic small town, very nice small town. Also, if you prefer the fine sanded beaches, because here we have all the possibilities, no? So we have also in this area, let's say, no? We have also fine sanded beaches. It's a very, very nice place, Grado. I have here also for you we have here the map of Grado, so you can take it. We have also here leaflets of the Castle of Duino. So then all this information is also here. So to arrive to Grado, you can do that also by boat, directly from here, from Trieste, in this case from Trieste, not from Grignano. So if you want to go directly to Grado, you have to go to Trieste and take the boat from Trieste. Trieste, the name of is very close to Piazza Unità. Piazza Unità Square, no? The name of the molo is Molo Bersaglieri. In Grado, the name is Molo Torpediniere. To go and come back, the price is around 10 euro. I have here also for you the time schedule and the cost. But the cost is that, so the time schedule, no? But that there is three possibilities. You can go, you can leave in the morning, you can leave during the midday, or in the afternoon, and the same to come back, no? But if you don't want to go by bus, also there is also you can use also the same bus that you will take to go to the international airport. That is the APT Gorizia 51 bus that you can take in the Strada Costiera. But there is also in this period of summer also the normal bus, that is the bus number 21. If you go to Grado, a very, very nice place also to visit, very close to Grado, but that is not in the, on the sea, but the name is Aquileia. It's a, an old small town founded in 181 BC. It's a very famous Roman archaeological site declared UNESCO Patrimony. And in this case, it's better to go first. The more the easiest way is to go first to Grado, and from Grado to Aquileia. It's very, very close, very near to the distance. It's short, it's really short. And there are APT, always APT lines, buses, line 22 and line 26. The picture, one of the picture on the left, of the picture of the right, shows some of the Roman rest. And on the left, I put that that picture because this is the picture of a church, very very famous and very nice, beautiful Byzantine church that is in Grado. So if you go to Grado, please don't forget to visit this church, and the entrance to the church is free. It's very, very nice, very, very nice church. But then this is more or less the thing that we have around. But if you have the possibility to go to Venice, I imagine that you all know Venice. It's a very romantic city with channels. It's a very particular city. And the best way to arrive to Venice is by train. I can help you if you need how to acquire the ticket. But you have to take the ticket, you have to go by bus, by the bus number 6 to the Trieste railway station, and take the ticket from Trieste Centrale, is the name, to Venezia Santa Lucia. And you arrive directly to the tourist Venezia, let's say, because there is also Venezia Mestre. Some of you, maybe you arrived, there is an airport, an international airport also to Venezia Mestre, but the place to visit is Venezia Santa Lucia, so you can take the ticket. The price, you need to arrive by train around 2 hours, and the price to go and come back is 25, more or less, maybe a little bit less, but it's around 25, but it's fantastic. You can visit and stay there all the day. It's a very nice place, and I recommend to go there. And this is about the site. I put also on the slide the site of the Trenitalia. Trenitalia is the site that I recommend to go if you want to visit any city of in Italy. Any city in Italy would have several possibilities at a good price. So this is the site you should visit. And then to finish the general idea, also by boat you can visit the coast of Croatia, and that very, very, very nice towns around the coast of Croatia. And then maybe consider it, but in one day, you can also go by train to Padova, Verona, the city, very nice city close to from here. And maybe if you want to go to Florence, for example, it's better to maybe take the whole weekend. And that's all. This is more or less the idea. Thank you. Sorry, my English is not the best.